Buenos días from El Salvador. We have a very beautiful morning here with our new Miss Universe 2023, Shaynice Palacios. Buenos días.
Good morning. Buenos días. ¿Cómo estás? How are you?
Well, I'm good. How are you? I wanted to ask you, first of all, have you slept? What was your night like for the first time as Miss Universe? Did you have the crown beside you? And when you woke up, what were your first feelings?
Well, I feel so excited. I was shocked in that moment. Estaba totalmente en shock. Uh-huh. I can't believe it, that moment. No podía creer ese momento. And when I saw all the girls and told me that, believe it, you deserve it, you deserve it. It was amazing, it was incredible. And then I just saw the Mexico, my roomie. When I saw her and told me deserve it, I feel like grateful. Grateful is the bad word that I'm describing that moment. And then when I walk in to the conference, yes, it was like, oh my God, there is a lot of people, yeah, and that's here because now I'm not only Shaynice, I'm Nicaragua. I'm now Miss Universe 2023. Oh yeah, my God. Y solo dormí dos horas.
Dos horas.
Dos horas. But don't worry, I'm so excited and I'm so happy to start working and to be a legacy, to leave a legacy for all the young girls and the women around the world.
Y estás trabajando ya.
Yes,
yes. Te gusta, estás enjoyando tu trabajo.
Yes, estoy disfrutando muchísimo estar haciendo fotos. I really enjoy to do photo shoots, to do interview. I feel great for this opportunity and grateful for the organization, for the judges, to see something special in me and for now to be a Miss Universe.
So last night you said that when I asked you who was the first person you called, you said you called your doctor.
So no, my doctor, my roomie, my translator, my translator.
Oh, yes, the translator,
yes,
said
yes,
room,
no,
doctor.
My roomie, my
okay,
roomie.
So I was wondering.
No, but I just want to talk with my roomie. Because yes, Miss
really?
Mexico. Because this morning,
yeah,
the last morning when I wake up was like, it's today, the last day, and she told me like, everything what happened today, it is a victory for us. Mm-hmm. So I feel that I want to tell her this in that moment, and she told me like, you deserve it. You really deserve it, and I still feel so so happy. And it's this moment, yeah, I'm shocked.
Still.
I'm shocked. Yes, I'm still shocked.
So, before coming to El Salvador, in most of the pageant sites, you were always the favorite, right? Coming here, and you saw that. I think you were the crowd favorite. So, how did it feel? Did you actually think that it would be easy to take the crown? Did you think no, or it would be very difficult, and that's why you're in shock?
Not really. I just only enjoyed the experience to share with the others, delegates, share the viewer experience in El Salvador. I do feel like a pressure, yeah, like responsibility to be at the top five in the mythology pageants. I just only feel happy for my country because this is a victory for us, for my people,
yeah,
and Nicaragua. And it's the, like the mythology in the top five is only one more.
Yes.
But important is how you feel inside the competition, how with the people inside the competition, how you compare with the delegates. That is the real reason because you feel happy or warrior.
Yes. Outside the stadium, afuera del estadio, the Nicaraguans estaba celebrating like como miedo.
I know. In my country, mm-hmm, all the people go to the street,
oh,
and celebrate that moment with a flag and toward the los pitos de los carros,
yes,
say pee, pee,
oh,
pee,
yeah,
pee. So celebrate this moment because it's history,
yeah,
for my country. It's give us happiness and hope and gave us a real victory.
Yes.
So it's amazing for me. It's amazing and I feel so happy and to say thanks God, thanks,
yeah,
organizations, thanks to the judges.
Yeah.
It's really unbelievable.
I saw you after you won, you were pointing up to God right away. So I
yes,
guess you were praying a lot during this competition.
Yes.
And how much is your faith helped you?
A lot. I am a Christian person, Catholic person, mm-hmm. and to me, prayer is a way that I feel more comfortable. I feel that my energy is to be controlled to God, and whatever what happened, God to know why it's happened, and the reason because it's happened is for to know a new version about me and about the or the delegates. We compete in this edition to Miss Universe. So when I say thanks God, it's yes. because this crown is not mine. It's for him. Aww. It's for all the delegates that I share with there, and it's also to my country and my family.
And now I hear that you're going to have your first trip to Mexico.
Yes, yes.
And then you're going to be going to New York. So what's going to happen in Mexico?
It's amazing. It's amazing because I never visited Mexico, so it's the first time I share with the people. And I saw maybe my roommate Melissa.
Oh, yeah,
yes.
Yeah.
And I don't know what it's going to do, but maybe after this interview, I know it. But I feel so happy to visit Mexico, to share with the people, to know that amazing country, and enjoy this moment in my life that is amazing.
And to live in New York and Thailand, right?
I think so.
You've been to New York before?
No, it's my first time. It's my first time. I'm going to tell you that it's a dream for me. I'm work hard for this, and now I'm here as a Miss Universe 2023. Is a real, I don't know how to describe
yes,
that
yes,
moment.
Yes.
I don't have that exactly word, but I feel so happy and to work a lot to bring a big legacy for the young girls, for the women, and for our society.
Yeah.
That is my mission, and now I am Miss Universe to give a wonderful, powerful legacy for all the people around the world.
Yeah, last question. Because your main advocacy is to help people with anxiety.
Yes.
Anxiety is one of the biggest problems today with men, women, and children. So
yes.
What would you say to people around the world, women especially, who experience anxiety? How did you overcome it?
Do you know something? I mean, I started that project because I am anxiety person. So this, from my experience, I want to help the people to bring the exactly tools to help people manage their emotion, because in that moment I don't have the tools.
Yeah.
Though my mission is to give us the right tools that they control their emotion and to bring a better society, emotional, healthy society. And
¿Cómo se hace?
Well, first breathe,
okay,
tense, and count. One, two, and thinking about the present, about what happened in that moment.
Mm.
No matter the past, no matter the future, only the matter is now.
Mm.
Because it's the only things that you need to concentrate to be comfortable, to be that you feel great. The other one that helped me
yeah.
is to play a puzzle.
Puzzle.
I love play puzzle and a mental play too.
Mm-hmm.
Play mental games. I love it. It's the other way.
Mind.
Yes, exactly. Because
right.
you can concentrate it at this moment
mm-hmm.
and organize the other
yeah.
pieces. So it's the other way that maybe people can use to feel more comfortable.
All right, Miss Universe has to go. She has so many things to do. Thank you for this short time, and please give some love to Filipino fans, and we hope that you'll come to the Philippines one day.
Yeah, of course. First, I want to say thank you, because with you I practice my English a lot. Oh, thank you for that. Second,
this was my first interview.
Yes.
You were my
yes,
first interview
yes.
here.
Then I want to say thank you to all the Philippines
yes.
that gave me their support,
yeah.
and thank you for being here, because I know that a lot of Filipinos was here to support the Michelle. Michelle is a great person, is a great friend. And ¿Cómo está? So, see you soon.
Okay, gracias. Miss Universo
2023.
Shaney's Palacios. Gracias.